All right, we're back. Notice how this built this classroom was marked with the blacksmithing hammer, even though the actual blacksmith is in couscous. Anyways, thought I'd be able to handle this, you know, for my training, but I can't. Here, you can have it. Silver hammer. All right, and we need that if we want to get another recruit, because Ryu's weapon needs to be at least level 15, and guess what the silver hammer can level... guess what level of sharpness you can get with the silver hammer? That's right, it's level 15. So, in order for us to get our next recruit, and probably the easiest one to check, as to whether or not your castle is at the maximum level, we're going to go back to the castle, give that hammer over to Tessai, and sharpen up Ryu's weapon, and then we're going to talk to the person in question and check to see if we can actually start recruiting the final recruits that requires us to have our max level castle. So, what are you going to say about the silver hammer? Can I raise your weapons to level 15 now? So, in a matter of like 5 minutes, we've given him all the hammers we can possibly give to him. You give them all to him all at once if you want to, but whatever. let's just do this, get Ria's weapon up to level 15, and there is one final level that we can raise our weapons to, and that is level 16. However, the hammer in question that you need, naturally, is the golden hammer. The hammer that we need is in an area that we still can't access yet. So, and we will not be able to access the golden hammer until the very end of the game. Anywho, where do we want to go? We want to go back to couscous. And if we do this, now that we have our weapon sharpened up to level 15, we want to take a boat out into the lake. And from here, we're going to go back to Coronet Town. Which is that one town just south of the Muse. Now, we can't actually go inside Coronet Town, but there is a recruit there that we can get if our weapon is level 15 and our castle is level 4. And this is going to be the thing that confirms whether or not we can actually get the final 7 or so recruits that we're missing. There's also one other character that's also very easy to check. And it's that one character in Raditown Town that I've been trying to get for a while now. But couldn't. He's that one friend of Simone. But here we have Genshu. You have something to say to me? Alright, so no, he is no longer meditating, but we can now ask him to join our group. And if Ryu's weapon is level 15, he will actually join us. I live by the way of the sword. I know no other path. Well, that's good for us since we're in the middle of war. Will you show me your weapon? Alright, yes we will. Oh, pardon me. It is a sharp weapon. So you're serious about war. Your strength has also been forged through hard battle. I'll be pleased to walk along the same path as you, Lord, for you. So he does not deem us worthy unless our weapon is level 15, and we got one of the last recruits we could possibly get in the game. Once again, we can't go inside the city itself, but he's just kind of hanging out there on the docks. So, now that we have that confirmed, let's go mop up the rest of the recruits that we can possibly get. And I think at this point, we are about ready to do some cutting around here because I have not gotten Ada yet, and she's kind of the reason why I've been wanting to do all this recruiting. I didn't want to actually go off and do the war battle at Muse just yet, because we're still missing Ada's war unit, and I think this is as good of a time as any to get her in our army. But first, for the sake of Let's Play purposes, I want to show just what happens. I want to show the recruitment sequence for the Krakens. So that means I'm going to have to get rid of my listening runes and then do a soft reset afterwards. Oops, did not mean to go all the way south. But we're going to go get Simone's friend out here on the docks to Reddit. And you got to have Simone in your party, obviously. And that will be enough to let us recruit our final party member here in the South Window region. Actually, wait, no, there's one more person that I'm thinking of. One more person left down in this region. And looky who it is. Returning star from Suikoden 1. It's Vincent. Was a bit of a sleaze bag back in the day, but well, I don't know, maybe he's just very haughty and very misguided in his aristocratic ways. Oh, Simone, I was looking for you, Simone. These two. Oh, Vincent, my friend, it makes my heart soar like an eagle to see your face again. I'm overflowing with joy. I was worried about you too, Simone. What happened? I'm sorry, Vincent, my friend. I cannot look you in the face. What are you saying, Simone? The rose brooch that you gave me is a sign of our friendship. I'm afraid I lost it. Even though Lord Vio found it for me, I feel as though I've betrayed our friendship. No, 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 what are you saying, Mes Amis? Please look this way. I can't do that, Vincent. I'm so... Simone, the rose fruit is just a trinket. But our friendship is what is truly precious, non? Vincent, you are the greatest friend I've ever had. Also, sprite animations. I love how, for this one little scene, they went all out on this. I don't know, maybe Vincent was supposed to be a more important character, but I don't know. He is returning from the first game, but he's just a side character in this game. Anyways, but of course, Simone. Vincent, my friend, let me introduce you to my friend, Lord Ryu. Pleased to meet you, Lord Ryu. A friend of Simone is a friend of mine. Vincent, I'm helping out the Dunning Army now. Of course, you could also. But of course, Simone. Well, Lord Ryu, shall we go? We walk on the path of honor. Alright, so now Vincent has finally joined. Vincent, I'll show you around the Dunning Castle. It's just filled with wonderful people. I can't wait to see it. And off they go. Anyways, back to the castle, and I should just go off to the right because the world map is there and I can teleport back to HQ. Alright, for the next two recruits, I decided to rearrange my party a bit. Today I'm only going for as high as level as I can with all my recruits, so I picked about all the high level characters I could possibly get. I'm not actually going to do any fighting, but we got some dungeon crawling to do. First and foremost, we're going to the Cave of the Wind. Yeah, back to this place where we got the Star Dragon Sword originally. And then later we came back here to get an item we needed for Hicks and Tengar's quest for recruiting Hicks. And there was like some kind of red rose or something here. But if we go through the Cave of the Wind now that we've reached the maximum castle level, we go all the way back to where the Star Dragon Sword was sitting, we'll find someone new there, and he's a very well hidden recruit, and someone you can only find if you come back here this late in the game. And this is the whole reason why I got all these high level characters, is just so I can let go of the enemies and not bother fighting anything as we just run through this cave as quickly as possible. Man, it's been such a long time since we initially met Khan, and then all that time later, we finally got to recruit him in Tinto. Anywho, we're pretty much towards the end of the cave, but yeah, we're going to get our last recruit that's here in this region. At least I think it is. Hopefully not forgetting anyone. You, not here either. You were you bastard, but he must be close. You're quite a ways off, dude. I mean, he's kind of in the same country that you're in right now, but you're about as far away from where he is in this country that you could possibly be. But yes, Pesmerja is once again a recruit here in Suikoden 2. He was also very elusive in the first game, to say the least. I mean, he had to get the max level castle in that game as well. Then he had to go all the way back to where you fought Necklord, which was at the top of that very tall castle, and it was a long trek back to the end of that place. A very long trek to the end of this place as well, but at least it's full of low-level enemies. Enemies, who are you? Dananarni. I see. So you must be Ryu. Did you say Uber? A devil, a shadow, my arch nemesis. Something like that. I can't describe him exactly. Kind of want to know, is that right? Ah. Well, please join our group. let me think. My true goal is to find Yuber. While I'm searching, I think I can help you. Okay, I'll do it. So, yet another character that's very much like Yuber, in the same kind of black armor that Yuber wears. Yes, please, come with me. Actually, Pesmerja is not. Never mind, he is very strong because he gets a lot of benefits. He retains about as much as you possibly could get if you re-transfer in from Suikoden 1. Remember my Suikoden 1 file that I used to transfer had everyone at level 99. And yes, I did a game shark, did use a game shark to do that back in Suikoden 1, but as you can see, he hasn't really lost his stride since then because he came in at level 75. But admittedly, he's not that strong of a party member regardless. Level aside, if you were doing this a normal playthrough, he'd probably only be like pretty close to the max level regardless. And that's why people like him so much, is that they look at him right off the bat and they see, oh, this guy must be powerful because he comes in such a high level. But admittedly, the thing about Pesmerja is he is locked in completely. All of his equipment cannot be changed. But the only thing he can change is one item slot, and it comes with the Bolt of Rat. Everything else is kind of mediocre. Well, Horn Helmet, I think, is probably one of the highest defense helmets in the games, as well as Chaos Shield. But these two things are kind of a bit lackluster. Knight Armor, there is better as well. In fact, if I had Humphrey still in my party, I'd show you that he has the Windspun Armor is better. Is a better piece of equipment than the Knight Armor. But this is probably one of the highest pieces of full body armor that in the game that does not have any special effects, but there is at least one better that I know of. Anyways, we're gonna do this again with another cave. This time, I am deliberately going back to Crown this time and not making a mistake. We're going back into the cave where, well, I think we actually saw the guy before. There was a wizard hiding in a cave back in the mines that leads between Tinto and the world map here. However, before we do this, I'm going to save my game because I think this time around I'm going to grab the Kraken that's in here and show you what happens when you recruit both of the Krakens in the Tinto mines. And then we're actually going to go and proper recruit the wizard because he's a lot farther in. And for the sake of making things easier, I've got two escape talismans so we can just go get both of the Krakens that are in here. And I can make this, well, it's just to streamline things for me at least. I mean, you won't notice. I'm going to make a couple cuts here and there. And we're going to go get Abysboa and the other Kraken that's in here. Now we have our castle level 4, and that was the other requirement of why I wasn't able to recruit the other Kraken before. For now though, I'm going to show the route at the very least. So if you're actually interested in getting both of the Krakens, you know what the route is. Regardless of whether or not you get these krakens in, I don't know if you're willing to screw yourself over getting the perfect ending, because I will make mention once again, if you get both of these krakens, the second one does not count on the Star's Destiny, and there is no other way to get more listening runes that you need in order to recruit at least two of the monsters that are Stars of Destiny. But if you don't care, at the very least, go to the Forest Village and recruit Ada, lose to the fight with the Griffins, and Ada will still join you, but you will not be able to get Feather, the Griffin that you rescue in the Forest Village. And we kind of went over this before. So, we're going to get Kraken number one. Abysmal, we saw this before, but I think for the sake of showing it all in one episode, and apparently he doesn't even say English, even though he can understand monster speech for the time being. Wait, no, actually, we didn't actually use the crystal. So we got to look at... Well, did he even say any words in that second text box? It was sounded like more like groaning either way. So yeah, I guess we can't understand Kraken speech regardless. Anywho, escape the talisman. But yeah, as I was saying, you definitely want to still recruit Ada because she does have her own war unit and war battles. And you definitely want to recruit here regardless, but you do have to lose to the fight against the three griffins that you fight in the Forest Village when you're going to recruit Ada and Feather.